Hello everyone, my name is Michael Cormier and today I will present our paper Where Are We with Human Pose Estimation in Real-World Surveillance. So, nowadays video surveillance is ubiquitous. We have surveillance cameras indoor, outdoor, in almost every public places, and shop, malls, and so on and so on. We have thousands of video hour footage for single places, and people can't even begin with analyzing this video footage. So we need methods to analyze this fast and automatically, ideally also in near real time. However, due to privacy concerns, we want to do action recognition, which is based on abstractions, on skeleton. Therefore, we need to extract pose information for multiple persons. In this case, we could say crowd pose estimation. Therefore, we ask the question, where are we with human pose estimation in real-world surveillance? Can we use the results from the academic papers on human pose estimation and apply them in the real world? What are the limitations? Are we able to recognize actions live, such as developing in this footage? Are we able to detect, track person in video footage, extract the pose, and interpret the actions? So, compared to academic datasets such as COCO or POSTRAC, in real-world scenario we have really challenging conditions. Here, as you can see in a tram station, we have multiple objects occluding the scene. We also have occlusions, we have problem with illumination changing all over the day, and a tram which is just driving around. So it's quite difficult. We have also really challenging condition with shadows. We can be detected as a person, some reflections from a smartphone in this case direct into the camera. We have a person if they're fighting, which are really near to each other and difficult to extract from another. And within the scene, we also have a strong variation in illumination. Due to the large crowd, we decide to use a top-down approach. First, we detect the person in the image, then we track them over time, and finally, we determine the pose. Let's see the detection part. The main problem for the detection in real-world surveillance is adequate training data. In our case, we use Panda for person detection. It has the advantage that it is a gigapixel camera in real world with a large field of view, hundreds of persons in diverse scenes in diverse images. However, the videos only have 2 FPS and no ground truth for human pose or action recognition. Due to the near real-time requirements, we are forced to use really fast person detector, such as one-stage person detector. In our case, we compare and train different variations of YOLO V3 and YOLO V4, as well as RetinaNet with a transformer backbone. We compare these different methods with transfer learning on a public and a private dataset for real-world surveillance and crowd pose estimation. As we can see, YOLO V4 Tiny is really fast with more than 260 FPS. However, its result is quite bad. Our model trained on Panda dataset achieved competitive results on all categories and also state of the art in most of them. As we can see, however, it has problem to detect a really big person due to the bias introduced by the Panda dataset. Let's take a look at our tracking component. So we decided to do visual tracking using a re-identification network, in our case OSNetX 1.0. We are applying different methods for data augmentations, such as random flipping, brightness and contrast adjustments, rotation in both directions, and use three different surveillance datasets in order to get stability. Our tracking achieved stable 10 FPS in extremely crowded scenes with 150 to 200 pedestrians. This means we achieve about over 100 detections per second. Detections smaller than 100 pixels in height are filtered out because they are too difficult for the pose estimation component. After that, we manage the tracks, and tracks with more than 60% missing detection within T frames are aborted. Furthermore, gaps within the track are filled by interpolation to assure temporal consistency for pose estimation. Let's take a look at our pose estimation. However, if we don't have ground truth detection, but only detection from the detector presented before, the performance drops significantly. HRNet remains undisputed state of the art on this dataset, however, it is much too slow, with 1 FPS. On the other side, the Transpose R model achieves 5 FPS. Therefore, we use the Transpose R in our next experiments. We show qualitative results for our experiments. In the second row, we saw the result for transpose R. In the third row, we see the result for transpose H. In some case, second column, the detector misses one detection. As we can see, both models are quite challenged and make different mistakes. We show our result for a crowded scene in front of a main train station. As we can see, we have several persons walking along. Some are sitting, others are far away, and a situation is developing here on the left. As we can see, our ReID tracking is quite stable. If we fix a person and follow it, the ID remains constant. We get several detections in the background that are filtered out for human pose estimation due to the small size. As we can see, our pose estimator is highly unconfident for pose it never seen. For example, person sittings. Also, due to distortion at the edge of the image, some poses are quite bad and the confidence of the human pose estimator is quite low. We could decide to filter out the ski points in order to get more stable results. In conclusion, there is a huge domain gap between scientific human pose estimation in academic datasets and real-world surveillance footage. Transform learning is not sufficient. We need more efficient method to annotate large amounts of human pose in such scenes in order to facilitate supervised learning. Furthermore, the temporal consistency for pose within tracks require improvement. As we've seen in our demonstration, pose over time unstable. This is a problem for modules following our pose estimation, which are targeted for action recognition. Finally, real-time requirements aren't fulfilled by human pose estimation in the real world. Future works may address this problem with semi-supervised learning, key point outlier detection and smoothing, and finally, the design of efficient and powerful architecture for human pose estimation for crowd pose estimation in real-world surveillance. Thank you for your attention.